Can a landlord raise rent in a pandemic? Yes and no. We're going to explain what that means. And we're going to cover exactly how much landlords can increase rent. We're going to talk about the rent increase notice, because there have been big changes in California. And stick around to the end, where we're going to talk about whether a landlord should raise rent. Hey there, Christian Walsh, Coldwell Banker Wire Associates. We're real estate brokers based in Southern California, helping tenants and landlords and buyers and sellers in California and beyond. And this is a big update and a timely one, as a lot of folks have reached out to us and asked us the question, can a landlord raise rent? So we are going to answer that one. And remember, we can't give legal or tax advice, but for the most honest real estate advice, subscribe to this channel. So if you're ready, hit that like button and we'll get started. So first off, who can't have their rent raised? Where can a landlord not increase rent? And in the state of California, there are some areas with a local moratorium, and right now they're usually the eviction moratorium. And the eviction moratorium will also prevent an increase in rents. So make sure, landlords, if you're going to do an increase, that you double check to make sure that you actually can during this time period. Of course, the other obvious one, a landlord cannot increase rent on a tenant who's under a lease. As the lease is coming to an end, a landlord can increase rent, but there's special notice it must be given. It also can't be retaliatory, which means it can't be for revenge for something, and a landlord can't be doing this to force you to move out of your unit. That's considered retaliatory, and that is not allowable as a rent increase. So when can a landlord increase rent? We're gonna run through this right now, but bear in mind that some areas have different regulations related to rent increases and regulations. So make sure you understand what those are in your local area. So rent increases can be done anywhere there isn't a moratorium on increases and on any tenants who are month to month. So how much can rent be increased? And this is an important question. We've done tons of content on this. AB 1482, the Tenant Protection Act of 2019 that went into effect on January 1st, 2020, dictates how much rents can be increased in the state of California. And we've done plenty of content on this, but we're gonna give you a quick run through. So the long and the short of it is there's properties that are exempt and there's properties that are subject to the bill. So properties that are exempt include any rental properties that are younger than 15 years. So that could be as big as 100 unit a complex or bigger. If it's younger than 15 years old, then AB 1482 does not apply. If it's a condo or townhouse, AB 1482 does not apply. And when I say it does not apply in these cases, I mean that there's no cap on how much that rent can be increased. Now, if AB 1482 does apply, and this is the majority of rentals in California, so this would be anything duplex or bigger, as long as the owner's not living in one side of the duplex. So if it's a completely tenant-occupied duplex or bigger, triplex, as many units as possible, then AB 1482 applies and rent increases are capped. Another important distinction of a house or a townhome is owned by a large corporation, they are not exempt as well. The intent of the bill was to make sure that large corporations didn't buy up tons of houses and still be able to benefit from the exemption from AB 1482. So under AB 1482, annual rent increases are capped on a property. The rents cannot be increased any more than 5%. Plus the consumer price index. The largest increase that can be done in a year is a 5% plus CPI increase, as long as that increase is no higher than 10% total. So if 5% and the CPI is 6, it can't go to 11, it stops at 10. So rents cannot increase. If CPI is 0, then the top is 5%. This maximum rent increase that we reference is based on the lowest rent that was charged in the previous year. So that's the other important point. That's going to set the bar for the increase. So a couple other important points. One is, just because there's a new owner does not change anything. It doesn't change the amount that it can be increased. We heard a crazy story. Somebody who said that their landlord told them because the mortgage for the new owner is higher, that the rent can be increased above 10%. That's absolutely not true. So nothing changes with the new owner. It's the property that's either exempt or subject to AB 1482. So if a property is exempt, so this is single family homes, condos, and duplexes where the owner lives in one side, if the property is exempt, that means that there is no cap on rent. Rents can be increased as often or as high as a landlord would like, as long, again, as it's not considered retaliatory. So what does an increase notice letter look like? What does it look like when we're going to increase a tenant's rent? What kind of notice do we need to give? Well, here I am levitating in the civil code that explains it. So this is section 827, and it's good to go to the civil code because I screw this stuff up too. I had to re-record this section because I was wrong. So let's see what the civil code says. Can't go wrong reading the law, right? So what this says is that in the case of any rental increase that is less than 10%, it is a 30-day notice to the tenant. So that is AB 1482. Everybody who's subject to AB 1482 is going to fall under this because your rent increases can't be more than 10%. So all of the tenants who are month to month will get a 30-day notice under AB 1482. For anything less than 10%. Now, this is the brand new part, and that this is if the increase is more than 10%. Well, how's that possible? Well, the property has to be exempt from AB 1482. So a single family home, condo, or a townhouse, or multifamily that's younger than 15 years, then a greater than 10% increase can be given in a year, but it will require at least a 90-day notice for a 10% increase. So that's what the notice of increase needs to have on it. The letter needs to have the appropriate time period, which we have just laid out in section 827 of the Civil Code. One last important point, if a tenant moves out, the rent can be set to market. And that's in most neighborhoods across California. The market rent will be the new rent when the tenant moves out. But here's a fun one. Should a landlord raise rent? And we're not gonna say yes or no. We're just gonna give some of the advantages and disadvantages. If a landlord does not raise rent, they lose their chance to go ahead and get that 5% plus CPI. If they don't do it every year, they're gonna get behind on rent. And that's one of the downsides for tenants in the Tenant Protection Act of 2019, and that is that actually property owners are encouraged to raise rents so they don't get too far behind the eight ball when it comes to rental rates. Some landlords used to let their tenants stay and give a small increase every once in a while, but that hurts them now if they try to sell because their rents are significantly below market and there's no easy way to get there. So I know tenants aren't gonna feel bad for landlords if their rents are below market, but ultimately it affects the value of the property and it affects how much profit a landlord makes. So that's one reason that a landlord may be encouraged to increase rent. But of course, we're in a pandemic and a tenant may be barely hanging on and barely able to pay what they're paying now. So that increase could push a tenant over the edge and the tenant may not be able to pay rent anymore. So that's one of the risks for a landlord. Landlords, if you push too hard, you may push your tenants to the point where they stop paying rent at all. And they're protected by SB 91. So as long as the tenant isn't paying rent due to COVID-19, and there is not any proof required, unless they're high income, which we've covered in other videos, but the tenant can stop paying and they're protected. They can't be evicted. So landlords, that's something to take into consideration if you're going to do a big increase in rent, that you may find that you have no rent coming in. Ideally, we'd like tenants and landlords working together to come up with a mutually beneficial solution. So leave your comments below. We want to know what you think. Should a landlord raise rents during a pandemic? We want to hear your opinion on it. So leave that comment below. Make sure you subscribe to this channel and also our free weekly email newsletter where we cover topics like this and more important things that tenants and landlords and buyers and sellers need to be watching in the real estate market 2021. This has been Christian Walsh, Coldwell Banker, Wire Associates, and we appreciate you.